I'm Yev.
And I'm James.
And we're here with another episode of Stocks and Storage. Today, talking about EBITDA. You know, one of the things that I've realized is that a lot of people just use a lot of jargon, both in tech, right, but also in the financial world. And they may not actually have any idea what they're talking about. Like, they'll hear these terms and they'll start regurgitating them as if it's gospel and they know exactly what they're talking about. The one that always trips me up, and I can never figure out a way to actually explain it in a minute or less, is EBITDA. I need your help.
Well, you know, it's not the most sexy topic. You're probably not gonna win any friends at cocktail parties talking about EBITDA.
I'll try.
But if you wanna work on yourself, start explaining EBITDA to people. It stands for earnings before interest, taxes, depreciation, and amortization. So first of all, it allows you to separate the operating performance of a business, versus like say the financing choices that you make or the tax laws in your country, right? So at the end of the day, like you don't have a lot of control of Backblaze of how the tax rate that you pay in the countries that you operate, you don't have to borrow money, but you could run the business with or without borrowing money, make it really rich. You could just have a big pile of money and not borrow anything. So the interest that you pay and the taxes that you pay really don't have much to do with how good a storage business that you run. Mm-hmm. So in some ways, it's a better way to look at companies so that you can kind of ignore, things like financing and tax rules. Now depreciation and amortization, that's a different matter. In our business, we have a storage business, right? We're an infrastructure business. And so most of our depreciation comes from hard drives sitting in data centers. It's an expense that we spread the costs of hard drives over multiple years.
We write about it with the hard drive stats.
That's right. Yeah, that's right. Part of the reason why people exclude, and amortization is very similarly, it's another way to spread expenses over time. So, but what's unique about depreciation and amortization, unlike a lot of other expenses, is that they are non-cash. Mm. So in some ways, EBITDA can be viewed as an approximation of cash flow. And at the end of the day, that's what everybody cares about as investors is, cash is king, right? At the end of the day, you give money to a company and make an investment, you do hope to get more cash than you put in at some point. So it has two advantages. One is levels of playing field, lets you look at companies kind of on a like-for-like basis, but also gives you a better view of the cash flow of a company potentially.
So using EBITDA as a metric for a company might be like saying it's how the company is doing before all the accountant-y stuff happens.
I mean, I think that works for you.
That's how I remember it.
Yeah, but yeah, again, it's a way to look at companies on a more apples-to-apples basis and also to kind of look at your earnings sort of more on a cash basis.
Nice. So when you say making an apples-to-apples comparison by using EBITDA, how do you mean?
So, basically, when we're evaluating a company and trying to compare two companies, you're trying to look at the actual operations and how they compare. At the end of the day, like interest and taxes, like those don't really have much to do with, say, running a storage business. That's a choice you make at some point when you're starting the company and funding it, whether or not you're going to borrow money or whether or not you're going to call your uncle and get a cash infusion. But if you're paying interest, that's really not reflective of how good a storage business you're running. That just reflects that you had to borrow money.
Economics.
So, yeah. So, and also like taxes, it kind of depends what state you're in or what country you're in. So, if you really want to compare two companies and, which is sort of better run, you could argue that removing interest and taxes gives you a better look at, how the two companies compare in terms of their operating performance.
Thanks, James. Hopefully that was a succinct and easy way to remember what EBITDA is. We'll see everyone on the next episode of Stocks and Storage.